In this video, we're going to be going over the area of a rhombus. We will define rhombus. We will explain congruent sides and angles. We will define derived units of measurements. We will show three derived units for area in the United States and three derived units for area in the metric system. Here we have a rhombus. A rhombus has four congruent sides. Congruent means the same or similar. They have opposite sides, which are parallel, and opposite angles are congruent. Now, some configurations of a rhombus can also be called a diamond. Now, we're trying to find the area of a rhombus, which is the base times the height. Now, at this point, we're going to explain derived units. Derived units where we have two or more basic units that come together to form another unit of measurement. The base times the height can also be looked at one length times another length. And when we put those two together, we have a length squared. Let's look at an example and show how to go through the area formula. Here we've drawn an imaginary line. This dotted line is not part of the shape, but it shows the height from one side of the shape to the bottom side of the shape. And our height is 8. Now we move on to B, which is our base, and our base is 7. 7 times 8 is 56, and our area is squared, so that's going to be 56 units squared. And if we were in America, that'd be 56 inches squared, or 56 feet squared, or yard squared. Let's look at another example. This time, let's use fractions. Again, we have our imaginary plumb line. You might hear other people say it. So we have 6 divided by 7. That's our height. The base, we have 5 over 7. So 5 over 7 times 6 over 7, that gives us 30 over 49. And again, that's units squared. So if we're using the metric system, we have millimeter squared, or it may be centimeter squared, or finally, meter squared. That's it for this video. Take care and thanks.